We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we are looking at Jawbreakers, Lost Souls. This is the infamous Indiegogo book that was supposed to be published by Antarctic Press, but this is the book that the big companies did not want you to see. So this is written by Richard C. Meyer, art by John Malin, coloring by Brett R. Smith, lettering by Eric Weathers. Now it also contains book one written by Richard Myers, art and lettering by Simon Bennett, and book two, written and lettered by Richard C. Meyer, art by Kelsey Shannon. The cover is by Ethan Van Sciver and Kyle Ritter, and the logo was made by Bob Stone. The cover is really cool. Ethan Van Sciver did a great job on the cover, as you would expect. Now, let's cover book one and two first. Book one has a more late 80s feel to it. It's a simplistic story about this team of superheroes going in and trying to complete a mission. And there's all sorts of little things kind of wedged in there. I don't want to get too down into the weeds with it because this story's been around for a little while. It was originally its own issue and it's been covered other places, but it's an okay story. The art's not bad. It definitely has an indie feel to it, and I didn't hate it or anything. It was okay. Nothing spectacular. Kind of a forgettable indie book, really, but it definitely compelled me enough to be interested in reading the next issue, which is in here, book two, which has a definite 80s feel to it. The art style from Kelsey Shannon here is way more 1980s G.I. Joe, and it's a much more compelling story. They're trying to find this God King person, and we learn some backstory, and people die, and all sorts of stuff happens. Now, that was a better story, honestly, than the first one, and I didn't hate that one either. I thought it was an okay issue. It's still kind of middle of the road quality-wise, as far as the writing goes. Now, when you get to Lost Souls, which is actually the first story in the book, and in my opinion, probably the best one, you can definitely see Meyer's evolution as a writer, because this is significantly better written. Now, as far as I know, he's only got a few stories out there. We did look at Iron Sights previously, which actually seems to have been written after this. Not sure on the timeline, don't quote me on that. Nah, I don't really care. This was a very well-written story about these soldiers being hired to take out this giant ape, but then they decide to go the other way with it. And there's a local warlord, and all sorts of craziness ensues, and you get to see these guys with, like, kind of minor superhero powers. They're not overpowered. They're actually, like, more like 1970s heroes. You know, they've got one or two powers, and otherwise they're very human. So it was a little more down-to-earth, grounded-level superheroes, and it's a little bit of a depressing story, actually, but it's very well written. The pacing is really good. There's good character development. You get a sense of each person having their own identity and personality, and it shines through in the dialogue. There were a few little things about the dialogue that I found a little quirky that I didn't care for personally, but that's how people are. So it was very true to life in many respects, and at least in the way people talk. I thought it was a lot of fun. It was very much like an 80s or 90s action movie, and it's how comics used to be back in the 80s and 90s. So I was really impressed with that. I thought it was a lot of fun. It was a good action adventure story about this quasi-mercenary military group of semi-superheroes, and honestly, I wouldn't mind reading some more about them. I thought this was a fun read, and I'm curious as to what the big deal was. It's an above-average independent comic book. This is the type of thing you would see as a series from Dynamite or IDW. It felt very much like Superpowered G.I. Joe, and that's kind of, I think, the intention to it. It was good. I would definitely pick up another book of these characters and read it. If it was an ongoing series, it might be on my pull list for a while, at least until it stopped being good. But Meyer's work has definitely improved since those two earlier stories, and even from Iron Sights, I would say this is a little bit superior to Iron Sights in writing. So I'm actually really impressed with this. I thought it was going to be very tepid and forgettable, but I don't see what the controversy was. This is not a political book. There's nothing rude or inappropriate here. There's just some normal superhero guys running around having a little adventure. There's no controversy within this. It was just an action adventure book that somebody didn't want published. And if they do another Jawbreakers book, I'll probably sign up to get it, because I really enjoyed this. I thought it was a good time. It's not a really deep story. It's got nothing overtly political to beat you over the head like most of Marvel books do, and a lot of DC does nowadays. This is just a good action adventure and fun for everyone. It's probably mature readers. I don't think young readers, maybe teenagers, would be okay with it, since there's not a lot of swearing, but there is a lot of death and stuff like that. I like the art a lot. I thought John Malin's a very good artist, and he did a fantastic job. The colors really popped. Brett Smith's a really good colorist, and everything about this story was fantastic. And it was nice reading the bonus issues in there, too. It definitely rounds out the book as a package, so it's nice to read those earlier stories and get a better sense of feel for the characters, but I think they were fleshed out more in Lost Souls than they were in the earlier ones. But I've gone on long enough. This is a recommend. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews, and we hope to see you on the next one.